Hello everyone. So today we are going to see IELTS reading section, how to solve list of headings. Okay, so list of headings. There are various strategies, but this is the one which I feel very easy, and this also gets results. It is easy to understand. So let's dive in and see the strategies. So first thing that you need to know is the question prompt. So the question prompt will look like this. The text on the next page has 7AG, okay? Here will be a text. There will be a few paragraphs A, B, C, D, okay? And another page or in the next area, you will have a list of headings, and here will be the place where you need to write the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or A, B, C, D, whatever. Okay, so you need to read the question. Okay, choose the correct heading for each section from the list of heading. Write the correct number 1 to 10 in boxes 15. Okay, so this question prompt you need to read very carefully so that you do not write A, B, C, D, or you do not write A, B, C, D near the headings, but you write your answers here. So whatever the question has asked, you need to write that. There is a slight difference that I would like to say you in computer-based reading and paper-based reading. In computer-based, you will be given a list of paragraphs, and at the opposite side, you will be given the list of headings. You need to drag and drop your answer. Okay, so if the answer is A, you need to click on that, drag it to the correct paragraph and put it in there. Okay, so in computer based exam, you need to drag and drop your answer. However, in paper based reading task, you just need to write down the relevant Roman letters, Roman numbers in front of these A, B, C, D paragraphs. Okay, so this is the main difference between the computer based and paper based match heading type. Okay, so let's see our answer. So this is a paragraph that we are going to see. Okay, so here is list of headings. Okay, there are 10. So the first tip is that there will always be more than number of headings compared to paragraph. Okay, so here if you see, we have 7 paragraphs. Okay, we have A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay, we have 7 paragraphs, whereas we have 10 headings. Okay, we have 10 headings. So always there will be extra headings, so do not get confused. Okay, and there are two methods to do match heading. Okay, one is that first read the headings and then do the paragraphs and match it. Another one is first read the paragraph and then match it with the heading. So we are going to concentrate on the second method. That is, we are going to read our paragraph, summarize it, know and understand what the particular paragraph is trying to say or what is the main topic of the paragraph, and then match it with our headings. Okay, so this is more effective as well as less time consuming. Okay, so the first one also you can do, the first one which I said, you read the headings, okay, mark the keywords. Okay, in each heading there will be some keywords, you need to mark them. For example, if the role played by the observer, so role played observer, this may be our keyword. Now you need to skim these keywords in the paragraphs. Wherever you find the synonyms or your exact paraphrased words of this in whichever paragraph, you stop there, read the complete paragraph, and then try to see whether it matches or not. Okay, so according to me, this is a bit time consuming because we need to come go back, we have to do it again and again, to and fro is too much times, which exhausts our timing. So that's why we will be concentrating on the second method, that is, we will read the paragraph, summarize paragraph in one sentence, understand that what that particular paragraph is trying to say, and then match that summarized sentence, that one line sentence, with our heading and see which one matches the best. Okay, this is first tip, read the paragraph, write it in one line, that what is the summarization, what the topic is telling about, what the paragraph's main idea is, and then match it to our headings. Second tip is that once you have finished taking out one heading, just strike it out. Do not again search for it. Do not again go for it. Okay? Eliminate it. Just keep on eliminating. And third one is, if you are stuck in one heading or one paragraph, just leave it for the later time. Just move ahead. Do not waste time if you are stuck in one paragraph. Just move ahead. Keep going. You can, after matching all other paragraphs, there will be left one or two that will be more easy to do it. Okay? You will have less time and you will have a better understanding till you come to that hard part. So if you are stuck, do not stop. Keep going, skip that paragraph and go to the next one, and keep going until you have finished everything. And then there will be only one paragraph which is left, which will make it easy for us to find which matches the best. Okay, so let's start. So as I said, first we will not read our headings, but we will read our paragraphs. So this is our first paragraph. Okay, so let's read it. The British Museum. Okay, so something about British Museum we are going to read. The British Museum is host to a wealth of historical artifacts. Okay, so wealth of historical artifacts means it has a wide collection of historical artifacts, historical things, it may be anything, representing the accomplishments of past civilizations. Okay, so it is talking about a British Museum that has a wide range of artifacts belonging to our olden civilizations. A Roman era drinking cup. So this is something talking about a cup. Okay, a Roman era drinking cup. So this may be a keyword because it is talking specifically about a cup. So a Roman era drinking cup would not, on the face of it, seem to be a contender to rival the museum's more illustrious exhibits. Okay, so though it is, sometimes you may not be able to understand few words, it's okay. Try to understand what that line is telling. Just try to understand on the whole what is it's trying to tell. So a Roman drinking cup would not, on the face of it, seem to be contender to rival the museum's more illustrative exhibits. So it is telling about a cup that may not seem to be a good competitor to some other greater artifacts. Okay, so some artifacts are very essential, very important, but when compared with them, this drinking cup is not too famous, or it is not that good or attractive for people. Okay, so something like this is talked in this sentence. So even if you do not understand some words, it's okay. Just try to understand and get the meaning of what it is talking about. After all, an ancient drinking chalice. Chalice means, again, the cup, that is a cup of olden time in which they used to drink juices or alcohol, whatever. So after all, an ancient drinking chalice rarely excites. Okay, rarely excites means it doesn't excite people. It only few times. Rarely means only very, very few times. Only sometimes it excites the attention of all. Okay. So after all, an ancient drinking chalice rarely excites the attention of all, but the most dedicated history buff or expert. Okay. So it is saying that it doesn't excite all. Okay. It doesn't excite, rarely excite the attention of all, but so this may be called our distractor or our keep linking words, but the most dedicated history buff or experts. So apart from few dedicated history buff, that is experts or who are passionate about artifacts, apart from them, no one is really excited about this drinking cup. Okay, so now we have understood that this paragraph is talking about a British cup or a drinking cup that, when compared to other important artifact, is not that famous, and apart from few experts, it doesn't excite or attract other normal people or tourists or visitors. Okay, so now we can say that this paragraph is talking about a drinking cup, okay, a drinking cup that doesn't excite. Okay, it doesn't excites many people, but only few. Okay, only few, these experts. Okay, it excites only few history buff and experts. So this is our summarization of one sentence. Even you can write out the keywords only. Okay, drinking cup excites, doesn't excite, only few people. Okay, so whatever you think that you have understood from the paragraph, just write it down. And now take this one and now let's match it with our heading. Even if you want, instead of writing it here, you can write it down near these list of paragraphs. Okay, drinking cup. Okay, drinking cup not exciting people, only few member. Okay, something like that. So now instead of going back and forth, we can just stick to one place. We have written it and now we can just easily match it. So something about a drinking cup, an ancient cup which doesn't excite people but only few people are attracted by it. So now this is our summarization of paragraph one. Now we will take this and match it to our list of headings. So start with the first one. Ahead of their time. Drinking cup not excites people. So not exciting, ahead of time. It is not talking about anything. It is talking about liking, disliking, attracting, not attracting, dull, something like that. So we can omit this. Moving to next. The role played by the observer. There is no role played by the observer, okay? Because observers are not keen on watching this artifact because it doesn't excite people. So definitely they are not going to play any role, okay? They are just spectators. So nothing talked about a role of observers. So we can omit this as well. Moving ahead. Hidden potential. There was no hidden potential in it. It was just talking that people don't like to watch this. So there is no hidden potential. It is clear that it doesn't attract anyone. So we can omit this as well. A limited appeal. Okay. This sounds something like this. Okay. Limited means very few, less something. Appeal means which attracts or calls out for people. Okay. Appeal. The dress was appealing. That means people were attracted towards it. Appealing means something that attracts or calls people towards it. So this is something relating to this, because here it says it is not exciting people, but only few. Only few people are appealed by this drinking cup. It also says a limited appeal. That means very few are appealed by this. Okay, so this is matching. So we will keep this on hold. Move on to the next one to be better sure that this one only fits. An amazing transformation. There is no transformation here, so we can omit that. No coincidence. Nothing about coincidence. It was just explanation that it was not attracting people. So that was explanatory paragraph. So there was nothing talked about coincidence, so we can omit this as well. A rough science. There is nothing about science in liking and disliking, so omit that. A hypothesis proven. There was no hypothesis proven. It was clearly saying that only few people are attracted by it because it is very old and it's just a drinking cup. So there is no hypothesis, there is no argument, nothing. So we can clear this out. An unforeseen consequence. So there was nothing mentioned about any consequence. If people are not attracted by this drinking cup, is there anything going to happen? No, nothing about that is spoken in the paragraph. So we can omit this as well. So now after eliminating everything, we have come to the conclusion that our answer for paragraph A is going to be a limited appeal. Okay, so now you can write it in your answer paper. Okay, in section A, you can write number 4. Okay, so number 4, a limited appeal. So now we are going to write in number 4. Appeal. Okay, so number 4. If it is computer based, you just need to drag it down, drag it and just take it to the paragraph and place it there. Okay, you are just going to take it and place it in your paragraph here and just drop it here. In computer based, in paper based, you need to write it down in the answer sheet. So this is the method that you need to follow to get your answer correct for a math heading. Okay, summarize. Okay, summarize the paragraph. Get one sentence of from it that what it is talking about. What is it talking about? Is it talking about a drinking cup? Yes, it's talking about a drinking cup. That is not very exciting for people, but only few people are attracted by it. Then we have got our summarization in one sentence. So now what we are going to do, we are going to match it with our headings. And after matching heading, it clearly understood that this is the answer. Sometimes there will be two of them which will look same. So what you can do is read word by word. Okay, each and every word should be matched with the paragraph or your summarization line to make it more clear that which is the best one. Okay, so let's take another example. Okay, let's move on to second part. So the second paragraph is, however, the Lycra cup. Okay, something called Lycra cup. I don't know whether the pronunciation is wrong. Lycra. Okay. However, the Lycra cup, so called due to the depiction of King Lycra. Okay. So some king named King Lycra, his cup, I think, is called a Lycra cup. So it was named after that king. On its outside is not what it seems. So what it is saying, this cup, which is named after this king, it doesn't is not what it seems from outside. Okay, from outside it is one thing, but actually it functions, or maybe it behaves in some other way. So this is somewhat the meaning of this line. Okay, lit from in front, the relief depicted on the cup glows green. Okay, so if this cup is lit from front. Okay, so if we put on fire or we start it in front, it glows green. Okay, so here the keyword you can say, from front it turns green. Okay, if it is lit from front, it turns green. If it is lit from back lit, the cup glows red. Okay, so when we lit it from backside, it glows red. So from front it glows green, from the back it glows red. This light induced color change is all the more remarkable given the cup's rather bland looking exterior, which holds no clue. Okay, it holds no clue as to its concealed secret. Okay, so what it does, what this line is saying, this light induced color change. Okay, so this color is changing, but more remarkable rather than bland looking exterior. But the simple, the flat exterior look doesn't reveals its secret. Okay, as to its concealed secret. So that means that cup from outside doesn't look that it holds something such mesmerizing talent inside it. Okay, so from outside it looks just a cup, it is blank, it is flat, nothing is attractive about it. But when you lit it from front, it glows green, and when you lit it from backside, it glows red. So there is a secret, only it comes out when it is lit. So something about secrecy. Okay, it transforms when it is ready. So we can say that secret, okay, a cup, this cup changes, okay, changes color. You can say it changes color, holds secret. Okay, holds secret. So we can say that when it is lit, it changes color or form. Okay, it changes into green or red. So this is its secret. It is revealed only when it changes its color. So now this is our summarization line. Okay, we have summarized this paragraph that it is something about its secret, it's something about changes. Okay, the changes that it goes, okay, this lysergus cup holds. So now we are going to match this with our headings. So just write it here as well. So now we have that it changes color. Okay, it changes color. So now we are going to match it again. So let's start with the first one, ahead of their time. So it didn't talk about anything that it was ahead of its time. It was just talking about how it transforms, it changes its color when it is lit. Okay, and it has some secret which is only revealed when it is lit. So we can omit this one. Moving ahead, the role played by the observer. So here a role was not played by the observer, but is talking only about that cup. So we can omit this as well. Hidden potential. Yes, this may sound similar because it's hidden, and here also there was talk about something that it concealed a secret. Okay, hidden, concealed. So something, hidden potential. It sounds, okay. So we will keep this on hold. Okay, a limited appeal, already we have finished for paragraph 1, so you are going to omit it so that you don't waste your time. Okay, a scientific failing. There is nothing failed about science. It was not about science. Okay, it was not failing. It was talking about how beautifully it changes its color. So nothing talked about science or its failure. So no. An amazing transformation. Okay, transformation. Changes. Yes, they are synonyms. It looks something amazing. Yes, from a flat cup it changes into red or green. Okay, so that is amazing actually. So this also sounds similar. So okay, we will keep this as well in hold. So we have hidden potential and we have amazing transformation. So we have two similar topics, so we will keep them in hold. No coincidence. There was nothing about coincidence in this, so we can omit it. A rough science. That is not science. That may be some science, but it's rough science. It is not rough science. It is doing that. Okay, it is completely doing this. So we can omit this as well. Hypothesis. There was no hypothesis, but it was clearly saying that it changes color. It is proven. So again, this will not be done. Consequence. Again, no consequence. It is an amazing thing that the cup is doing, transforming. So that is not a bad thing. That is a good and amazing thing. So again, we can conclude that. So now we have two: hidden potential, amazing transformation. Now, as I said, when you have two similar headings, word by word, if you see which describes your summarization or paragraph best, you have to pick that out. Hidden potential. Yes, it was hidden potential. Okay, it is hidden, concealed secret, but that potential. Not potential, it is just its hidden secret which comes out. Okay, it's not potential, but actually it is a changes, it's a unique feature, you may say. So it is hidden is fine, potential is not fitting so good there. Whereas if we say this amazing, yes, it is amazing that it changes its color when lit. From back it grows red, from front it goes green. So that is amazing. Transformation, yes, definitely it changes. It says that whenever it is lit from front and back, it changes. It glows red. It glows red. It transforms from a bland looking exterior. It changes into red color, green color. Okay, it changes. It transforms its look. From exterior to interior, it transforms its looks. So again, this keyword also matches. So when we see that all the keywords are matching with our summarization or with our paragraph, then we are going to conclude with this. Okay, so amazing transformation is best suitable heading that we can give to our paragraph B about the cup. Okay, so we are going to write the number. So in your computer base, you are going to drag and drop it. In paper base, near section B, you are going to write the number. Okay, the Roman number 6, an amazing transformation. Do not write an amazing transformation. No, that will give you wrong answer. The question asked us to write number 1 to 10 in the boxes 15 to 20. So you need to write the numbers and not the words. Write the numbers. So be clear what the question has asked, or most of the time you need to write the numbers or the letters A, B, C, D. Okay, so just be clear on that. Okay, so hope you have understood that. Let me repeat again. So the best method to do maths heading is that read your paragraph, summarize it into one line, that what this paragraph is talking about, what is the main topic of the paragraph, and then write it near your paragraphs, your main headings, and then one by one start matching your summarized line with the match headings. And once you find the best suitable heading that suits your explanation, match it and write, whether in the paper or you drag and drop in the computer base, that is up to the marks and your examination mode. Okay, so just follow these methods, and once you have finished your heading, just strike it out so that you do not again confuse it with other paragraphs. And always remember, there will be more headings compared to your paragraphs, so again do not get confused. Stick to the best one describing your paragraph, and in one place or in any paragraph, if you are stuck, no issues, move to the next one, complete other ones, and then you will have better chances of matching that left out paragraph with the best heading. Okay, so hope this is useful. Now practice, 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 because only practice will make you perfect. Good luck.